Hello, and welcome back to the Stronghold. I'm the Magi, and, well, ever since the budget perspective for the most recent murders at Karlov Manor set, I've been pretty vocal about how good I think Izzet Artifacts is shaping up to be. In fact, this particular archetype has gone from, well, basically not existing to being a substantial blip on the budget radar in just two sets. That's right, in Standard, before Lost Caverns of Ixalan, this archetype really didn't exist. Captain Storm kind of put it on the map in Caverns, and now we've got Gleaming Geardrake coming along with Murders. And, well, this one is shaping up to be really good. I had talked about this last season during Lost Caverns as a historic artisan insole artifacts archetype built basically around some other cards. And, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for an update.
But before we get into all that, just a quick reminder that the Stronghold is producing content for you across a number of platforms. And Patreon has recently introduced an option where you can follow our content there without the need for any financial commitment. So even if you aren't ready to support the Stronghold is better positioned to support you. So you never miss out on a thing. Now, what were we talking about? Oh, yeah, right.
All right, so what do you say we break down this Izzet Artifacts deck? In column one, I've got what I just consider the basic artifact package for a deck like this. Four copies of Gingerbrute, and then a single copy of a High-Speed Hoverback, which comes in with Flash, has Flying, Crew 1, 2-2, and... oh yeah, taps down a creature when it comes into play. Pretty good stuff. Urbrass Forge, which will make a non-artifact token every single turn, but it is an artifact itself, and it can bring a lot of potential power over a few turns. Atrexus Skitterfang is, well, a 3-mana 2-2, and on each of your combats, you can choose to use one of three oil counters to give a target creature you control your choice of Flying, Vigilance, Death Touch, or Lifelink until end of turn. Really nice Swiss Army Knife style thing, helps to break up the board very often. From here, we've got in column two just basic creatures for this style deck. Spyglass Siren, of course, is a 1-1 for one, evasive, and brings a artifact map token with them. Oaken Siren is a 2-of, 2-mana, 1-2, Flying Vigilance, also taps for a blue mana that can only be spent to cast artifact spells or activate artifact abilities. Red Herring is a 2-mana, 2-2 with haste, must attack, but has an onboard clue ability to sack itself and draw a card, which can be kind of nice, especially when it gets into a situation where it can't really attack effectively. From here, we've got column three, which I lovingly refer to as the tricks. We've got a one of diamond pickaxe, indestructible equipment that makes treasure artifact tokens, equips for two, gives +1/+1. Voltage Surge is a 2-mana instant direct damage to creature or planeswalker. If you sacrifice an artifact, it ramps up to 4 damage instead. And you have some artifacts that you could consider sacrificing to that. And of course, a 3 of Zoetic Glyph, 3-mana enchant artifact. Enchanted artifact is a golem creature with base power 5/4 in addition to its other types. When Zoetic Glyph is put into the graveyard from the battlefield, discover 3. Now, we've talked about a couple different ways to use this. Of course, you can use this on things that are evasive, like, Gingerbrute, High-Speed Hoverbike, anything that you give the Skitterfang ability to, Spyglass Siren, Oaken Siren, the map token, Well, actually, I take that back. You can't use it directly on the Siren, but you can use it on her map token. I misspoke there. Column 4 is the main artifact synergies here with Captain Storm, putting +1/+1 counters on a pirate, which is mostly herself or Spyglass Siren or Oaken Siren. And of course, we got Gleaming Drake, the star 2-mana 1/1 evasive flyer, brings a clue token into play with them. And whenever you sacrifice an artifact, put a +1/+1 counter on Gleaming Gear Drake. Really good stuff. Crime Novelist also likes it when you sacrifice artifacts, and in fact, they like it so much, they get a +1/+1 counter and give you back a red mana. Speaking of red mana, you can tap Krenko, a 3/3 for 3 with haste, and sacrifice an artifact to put a +1/+1 counter on each goblin you control. Whenever an artifact is put into a graveyard from the battlefield, you may pay 1 red. If you do, create a 1/1 red goblin creature token. It gains haste until end of turn. And the way you arrange these on the stack is your new goblin comes into play before the +1/+1 counters are distributed, so it gets bigger too. And don't forget, Crime Novelist, also a goblin that makes red mana to give to Krenko. Good stuff. Harry Dronesmith, this is a 3 of here, a 4-mana 2/3 human artificer, and at the beginning of your combat, you create a 1/1 colorless Thopter token, you do your combat thing, and then you sacrifice that Thopter token at the beginning of your next end step. So that is going to trigger all of your sacrifice stuff, including Krenko, Crime Novelist, and Gleaming Gear Drake. And it's an artifact when it enters, so Captain Storm's going to like it too. And of course, we've got Detective Satchel. When it enters, you investigate twice. It's a 4-mana artifact. You can tap it to create a 1/1 colorless Thopter artifact creature token with flying. Activate only if you have sacrificed an artifact this turn. And of course, we're going to be doing those things. Overall, that is the basis of the deck. I kept the mana here pretty simple, just for budget purposes. Of course, it's well worth upgrading. 18 basics, 8 islands, 10 mountains. We've got your Shivan Reef, because that is your free rare dual land for the year. Mirax is a recently made recommendation for crafting. The reason I like this so much for this deck is you can pay 3 and tap it, create a 1/1 colorless Phyrexian Might artifact creature token with Toxic One. And of course, you can do that at instant speed to mess with people's combats, to trigger abilities like on Gleaming Drake, Crime Novelist, and Krenko's activated ability, all potentially messing around with combat scenarios. Crime Scene is an uncommon artifact land that has an onboard sacrifice to draw a card. So once you don't need it for land anymore, you can just sack it off to do all those triggery sort of things. And of course, Thran Portal is my favorite pseudo pain land, dual land for the year. I think everybody should have one of these and basically put it in every single deck that you have.
Now, obviously, this is just one of many, many ways you can build this deck. Artifacts are a big part of Standard right now, so don't be afraid to take a look at your collection and make this list your own, particularly if that happens to save you some wild cards. And of course, if you're watching this video post the Murder season or up to 2.5 years in the future, Standard is going to wax and wane, so these deck lists are going to need adjustment both on day 1 and day 900. So play with it, figure out what works for you. What I have posted here is not the end all and be all, and in fact, it has had very little testing at this point. I am more talking about a potential archetype that I see developing within Standard, and I think you should be paying attention to as well. And before we go, I want to take just a moment to thank my totally awesome patrons for supporting me and allowing me to apply my passion into a community. And of course, before we go, I've got some suggestions for your next step.